There are wads of VGSG music here, and I'm so super excited to finally present to you all VGSG's Full-Fledged Flash. You already got the scoop on this library. If you're subscribed to our newsletter, you can do so by going to VGSGmusic.com. And we just went ahead and decided to make a newer flagship product. This is, of course, for the Montage only, Yamaha Montage, because we are going ahead and taking advantage of the full 1.8 gigabytes in your Montage. Biggest question we get all the time after getting our MOTIF Gospel Sound Pack is, what else could I fill the flash with? It's like an itch for some people, which I actually can fully understand. You want the best sounds you can get in this keyboard, and especially knowing it's possible after hearing, you know, my sounds. You want to fill up that flash to its capacity so you feel you've gotten the best of the best into your Montage, and rather out of your Montage. And with this pro product, I believe you have that. So it's our MKS20, our MOTIF Gospel Sound Pack, rather, library. Some of the previous sounds we've had in other past libraries, like our VGSG's MKS20 Sounds Pack. For those who've been with me since day one, you remember that contact library from 2015. Massive library, but we brought over Piano 2 and EP1 Chorus from there. We have Classic Times 2 sounds in here. We have our EX5 library sounds in here. We have our VGSG's Legacy MOTIF Presets Pack in here. And most importantly, in an eye catcher, is our XV5080 sounds. So let's just hop right into this, all right? Now, this is one I have to highlight real quick. Jazz Grand, we did bring that to the Montage. This is actually the first time we brought this, you know, we have brought this to the platform, period. Now, this isn't actually sampled, however, it was modeled, however, using internal waveforms, simply because the samples we already put in here already fit the max. So we thought we'll just go ahead and try and recreate it using, you know, internal waveforms. And I think it's a fairly good job. Of course, we have all of our classic ES presets here. You guys seen this a million times. Now, we have also went ahead and done some dedicated S700 stuff. So, right here is actually the internal preset of the S700 Grand. We actually just added Montage on it just to get that moniker, just to let you know. This comes factory with the board. You don't purchase anything from anybody. You buy it from Yamaha. You know, unbox the Montage, start playing. You'll find this patch within the factory presets. However, what we did was two things. So, firstly, what we did was we noticed that the compatibility reaches back. It's native with the XS and the XF and the MOXF. But we also found that it's also native, you know, besides the FM stuff, FMX, it's also native with the S90, you know, certain S90 boards. So I believe it's like the S90XS, the X90XF. And while it's a bit convoluted to get those presets on here, it's much, much easier because, while of course this library has sounds from like the classic MOTIF and the ES and whatnot, you know, it is possible to get those actual presets converted. You know, it's a bit harder because you need the actual physical board. With the S90 XS and XF, however, it's much easier because as long as you have the files in that certain format, you don't need to go get those boards. You can download certain editors and keep up converting from editors to finally getting it onto the Montage. So we did that. So, of course, we had the original S700 Grand Montage sound plus the natural S90 XS Grand, plus some edited S700 patches, and what those were from was, we noticed with the older boards, they had the S700 Grand, and then like dark and bright patches. Well, I wanted to bring those back. So over here, you're also going to see VGST's bright S700 and VGST's warm 700. These are taking the internal S700 presets, but using the patch data that made it bright and dark from the original S90 XS boards. Because, you know, I can tweak it myself, but if you already have that original patch data that has the sounds already tweaked, that's even better. And you're definitely going to hear a difference. The second part I wanted to get to as well was I noticed in some of the lower velocities, and you might not hear it in the video, but right there on that key, you can hear it pretty good. Unfortunately, I can't control the volume too much. But try it out for yourself with this patch on some of the keys, the samples. For this patch particularly, the factory preset S700 Grand patch, the lower velocities on some of these samples click. And I never understood that because you'll be playing real nice and soft and you'll hear click. And that has to do with the programming of the patch, not the samples. Because we're going to use the same samples in this bright S700 and warm S700 and you don't hear the click. So I thought that was very, very important to get those patches in there to get rid of that click. That's all we got for the S700. Now I want to go over to the S90 real quick. Now this will show you the difference here. Let's go bright and then we'll go back to the regular patch. So it's immediately louder, I can tell you that much. So you can hear it sort of, you get the brighter sound. Let's go back to the original real quick. Let's try it again with the bright. I think it's overall fuller, and I promise you, it's the exact same samples. We didn't add any S700 samples in here. It's just that when you edit patches, as most of you know, patch editing can make the difference. Now here's the warm. As you can tell with it being warm, you still get a little bit of brightness, but it's not as harsh. Big difference, right? It is beautiful. That patch, you know, has a certain spot in my heart. So let's move on here. This is a black upright. We featured this in version 3.1 of the MOTIF Gospel Sound Pack. That's just amazing right there. Move on. This is our coveted EX5 suitcase. This is my most favorite electric piano from my EX5 library. And instead of bringing over the FDSP stuff, which is a little bit heavier and file size, I decided to bring over the suitcase. Thank you. I hear the 5080 sound is promised. Now, there's one thing I wanted to show you guys actually on here. So I want to teach you really quickly how to actually create that sort of LFO wiggle. It's actually very simple. So I'm going to just do a little teachable moment here in the midst of doing this video. So of course, we select the mod wheel. I'm sorry, I go to mod control, control assign. I hit auto select, and then I move the mod wheel, and it points to the mod wheel. And then we go to element, ELFO, PMD. And then I usually put this, let's see how it behaves right now. Say 24 is pretty good. And all you gotta do after that, hit store, then hit overwrite. And now we're done. So that has been created. Hit the home button and then look at that. All right, that's it. Now this one has it set to aftertouch already. Moving on here, let's go back to our category search so you can see all of them. Now someone asked me how I do that. That's just the mod wheel. Warmer from the EX5 library. This also has its coveted filter on the mod wheel. Alright, so let's talk about this one next up. This is Flying Waltz. A lot of people were wanting this sound for a long time, but there's an issue with it. And that's simply, this is a very complex pad. There's four tones. Any synthesizer, Roland synthesizer you play this with becomes at four tones. And they're all firing off within a certain BPM at certain speeds. So one is like a drone, one is like a fast sound, and it's very hard to loop. So what I went ahead and did was loop this at 8 seconds. Well, it's an 8 second sample, and it loops, but not every single key loops perfectly. It's a very, very complex drone pad, and if it does not sync with the loop exactly, it will go out of sync. So most people I know who are playing this sort of have a sample and hold type approach with it. But the key is just don't hold it too long so the samples don't go out of phase. We tried to have this the best we could in terms of, you know, with the sampling and the looping, but it's just very complex. So while it sounded good by itself looped, with all the keys together, sometimes it might go out of loop or out of phase rather after you hold it down after a certain period of time. But, you know, just that initial press after about 5 seconds, it's great. So it's going to be great for your tracks, great for recording. But just, you know, prolonging that sustain is going to be kind of rough because not every single sample is perfectly in sync with the loop once played all together. So I'll give you an example. And I'm playing this in a very specific way to where, you know, all the samples are pushing off at the same time. If you do a roll, it's not going to sound that great because we can't get, you know, there's no way to get these samples to sync, you know, with this, you know, internal clock or anything like that because they're just samples. See how it's sort of firing off all differently. If you play it, you know, all at the same time. And you notice just right there, as I just listed off the keys, you'd notice sort of the samples going out of sync. So it's rough. You know, the longer you make these samples, the more flash memory you're gonna you know, take up. But it's one of the main reasons I don't usually include extremely complex pads or drones like this, because it's very, very hard to auto loop. Or even hand loop. A lot of these were hand looped. Half auto loop, half hand loop. But it is there and it does work for the most part. Mm-hmm. So there we go, Flying Waltz. Let's move on here. So for those who have never been introduced to VGST's MOTIF Gospel Sound Pack, we have loads in that product and in this product, loads of performances with click tracks built in. They can also have their tempo changed. And if you hit name right here, you'll see it says click track right here. So let me unmute it. We can go ahead and tap this tempo up here and make it slower or make it faster. Now you're probably wondering here, well, are we gonna have to use this performance here for our shouts and whatnot? No, we have plenty of that, and we're gonna get to that here in a second. That's the pretty layer. Also, all of our performances with click tracks, the click track can be adjusted via the super knob. But with the super knob, you can hear the click track change in volume. Let's see. let's see here. Now these here are templates. We've been asked to do this for a very long time, and pretty much what this is you know, hit any key, shot click starts, and then what you can go ahead and do is add your layers. And then what you can do from there is, you know, hit store, save it. There you go. Now you got your own templates with the shot click. And this applies to everything. Churchy, groove, and worship. All right. Now the following sounds here that we're demonstrating all just make up the rest of the user bank from VGSC's Legacy MOTIF Presets Pack. And in the interest of time, we're just going to hit some rather notable ones. You can see all these on that product page's And we're just going to hit some memorable ones here in the interest of time. This is a favorite of mine. As a favorite of mine is to play around with. That's a real fun one. Let's see, Church Ooze. It's a simple one. Seraphim is another one of mine. That's just crazy. Don't know if you'd use that one too much in church, but it's, again, it's a wonderful, nice little one. Let's see. Third Heaven actually comes from a MOTIF Gospel Sound Pack, where we bundled it in with these pads just so it's out of the way of the main presets. And what Third Heaven pretty much is Forest Horizon, Fifth Atmosphere, and I forget what the third one is, or the fourth one. I think that's a whisper. That would be real nice to put like an arpeggio on that behind a, you know, like a click track or something like that. So yeah, that is it, ladies and gentlemen. This is it. This is the big one. This uses up all of your flash here. So now you can have the ultimate here. You can see right here, I'm tapping up here. 1.8 out of 1.8. This is filled to the max. Everything you need for absolutely everything. So thank you guys so much for watching. This is available on VGSUmusic.com right now. And existing customers have been emailed about cross-grade prices. But for those who have never purchased from us before, again, VGSUmusic.com. Get this library for your montage right now and fill it up to the max. All right.